The primary elections in Maine were a week ago tomorrow, and it won't be until tomorrow when we know for sure who won the Republican primary for Congress in Maine's 2nd District.
Yeah, as well as 5 primary races for the state legislature. The Secretary of State will announce ranked choice voting results tomorrow morning. Newsletter Maine's Don Kerrigan is in Augusta tonight. And Don, this is all happening as Maine Republicans continue to try to block ranked choice from being used in the race for president, right?
That is right, Cindy. We're outside the Cross State Office building. That's where the ballots are all being compiled for over the last few days for ranked choice voting. This year's process does seem faster than the last time, but it is still just not quick. So as a result, the actual count to get the results in ranked choice voting will happen tomorrow morning. The process of gathering ballots had been going smoothly since Thursday night. But a few missing towns in Penobscot County slowed things down Monday while couriers picked them up. There isn't a lot of suspense in this CD2 race. Dale Kraft wound up with about 45% of the vote. And even though opponents Adrian Bennett and Eric Brakey both conceded, the law still requires the ranked choice count to be used. Meanwhile, the effort to stop the spread of ranked choice voting may be headed back to court. The Maine Republican Party turned in petitions back in June to force a people's veto referendum on using ranked choice in the presidential election. But last week, Secretary of State Matt Dunlap ruled against Republicans, saying the petition drive didn't have enough valid signatures.
We're going to appeal it.
Republican Party Executive Director Jason Savage says they think Dunlap is wrong and will take the issue to court.
And by looking at the categories of things that were used to disqualify them, we know that a large number of those people were registered Maine voters who want to repeal ranked choice voting. And for a series of technicalities, their signatures are being disqualified. And we want to make sure that everybody's signature is counted.
You just can't say, well, they're all registered voters. We know it. Let's just accept it. That's not, you know, the requirements of the Constitution are simple, but they're exacting.
Dunlap says there were problems with thousands of signatures.
A bunch of them had already been invalidated when they came to us. So they had their submission announcement where they said they submitted 72,512 signatures. But in fact, you know, over 3,500 had already been invalidated by towns because they were not registered to vote in those towns.
Dunlap says there were also 2,000 duplicate names and other problems. In the end, he says the petition fell 1,700 names short.
It's really going to come down to getting into the granular details of the disqualifications.
Jason Savage says he and the Republican Party aren't stopping, and he plans to have them inspect every petition and name, hoping to prove the party's right. So that process will unfold in the weeks ahead. Tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock, the count will be announced for the ranked choice for the 2nd Congressional District and those 5 legislative races. Then all the winners will get started running for the general election in November. Cindy, back to you.